Back at it again with another copyright strike abuser. So, what's this one about? Well, a YouTuber decided to react to someone else's content and the person that they reacted to had hurt little feelings because someone was making fun of their work that they decided to strike it down and hopefully get the channel gone. So, let's begin with the beginning. Right, our victim in this is called Cold Raven, who, if you do not know, was actually one of the very first people who actually outed EDP445 for being the Cupcake Man. So already he has a track record of, you know, dealing with degenerate freaks. But this kind of freak where he decided to react to was so salty that he struck not one, but two of his videos, and he was threatening a third one, which would have terminated his whole channel, which pretty much slayed. To Cult Raven pretty much begging on Twitter for any commentary channel, big, small, whatever, to help with this, to show how much of a degenerate freak this guy is. And he also said in the tweet, I believe that he was actually, you know, in contact with this guy, basically to try and explain that it was fair use and that he transformed the video. And the freak decided to just tell him to go fuck himself and that he's going to keep the strikes up. So it's quite disgusting that we still have copyright strikes like this happening to this day and that YouTube has not decided to change its system. Because if you actually see the video that Cold Raven made, he actually shows it from a 14 minute video, less than 1.5 minutes of said videos is actually the content that he'd reacted to. And he was actually pausing and discussing what he was seeing and giving his reaction to it. He wasn't just letting the full thing play and then just going, wow, cool, ugh. Like, he's actually giving transformative opinions, but this guy was so fucking salty that he actually had to copyright strike this. So, since this guy likes to, you know, copyright strike people, I will not be showing any of his videos in this new video, but I will be telling you his name is actually called Gay Roommate 2020, and the content he makes is, yeah, that it's disgusting and it absolutely is abhorrent. It actually made my skin crawl. And do you know what? Fuck it. I'm not going to show you this, but I'm just going to quickly read some of these titles to you so you can get understanding of what the kind of degenerate freak we're dealing with here. Right. The first thing we have from his latest thing is Fluffy Pony Abuse Comic Part 2 Voiced Over. Seriously, how is this kind of stuff allowed on YouTube? Like, people get striked for like such the simplest things, but yet this creature is allowed to actually continue on making these kind of things. And do you know what? I'm gonna say this. The fact that he has almost 50k's worth of subscribers shows that freak sells and that disgusting fetishes that he is doing sells. And you don't believe this is a fetish? Let's see. Let's read the next one. Puppet Show, Other Fluffies, Weird Fluffy Pony Comic, Fluffy Pony Abuse, Pony Abuse, Pony Abuse, Mystery Flow, Taking Pigs, Fluffy Box, Pony Abuse, Pony Abuse. Like, it's just, and all the thumbnails are either fat, obese, ponies, slash animals, or they're extremely anorexic and are disgustingly thin to the point where you can actually see their ribcage and all their organs and all that. And there's even like things where they have them impaled and all that, or they're lying on hooks, or they're wearing diapers. It's just disgusting. And the fact is that this channel is still up and running is even more abhorrent. And somehow after all this came out and obviously other people started talking about it, he started playing the victim. So I want you to keep in mind something before I read like his little community things. Remember, he told the guy he was copyright striking to go fuck himself and to basically say, oh well, haha, I'm gonna keep them up anyway, right? So how did he respond to this? Well, he said, the sad thing is, if I ever wanted to take back the strike again singly, I cannot. That would be rewarding the behavior of his followers. They threaten people like us. This is how they get their way. Even if I did, I'm sure this wouldn't stop. So the decision has been made, and underneath is a picture of basically someone giving him like a death threat and threatening to, like, you know, oh, we know what school you're working, so and so, and we'll get you fired and all that crap, right? And I just want to quickly say something. If someone's sending you a death threat over the internet, it's not real. It's not gonna happen. Stop playing the fucking victim. We know what you're doing. You got caught because you acted like an arsehole, and now because of that, you're wanting to play the victim and try and get the heat back onto him. It is genuinely so disgusting. Just take down the fucking copyright strikes and say, sorry, my feelings got hurt. That's all you have to do. But no, you're just going to be a sad little bitch and act like a retard and continue on to play the victim. So, if you'll excuse me, I have to go bleach my eyes after reading all of those thumbnails and seeing those pictures.